Hey.
Hey.
Do you want my number?
Sure. More?
Hey, do you think you can multiply this?
I 100% can.
I bet you're all wondering, what is Mole Day? Well, you see, Mole Day is an annual holiday that takes place every October 23rd from 6:02 a.m. to 6:02 p.m. We celebrate Mole Day to commemorate Avogadro's number and to spread interest in chemistry. Schools across the U.S. and even around the world celebrate Mole Day by doing various activities that involve chemistry or moles. Mole Day was founded by Maurice, and she has a really rad last name, I just don't know how to pronounce it. And she's a retired high school teacher from Wisconsin.
Before we talk about Avogadro's number, let's talk about who Avogadro is. Amedeo Avogadro was an Italian chemist who was born in Turin, Italy. He was born on August 9, 1776. He was born into a noble family of lawyers. He followed his father's footsteps and earned himself a doctorate of law in 1796. He then developed an interest in natural philosophy and mathematics. He left his legal career of law to teach mathematics and physics at Liceo High School in Vercelli, 1809. Now let's talk about the discovery of Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number is 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd power. How did they get that number? Well, you see, chemists were trying to bridge the gap between the invisible world of atoms, molecules, and grams. 1811, Avogadro theorized that equal volumes of gases at the same temperature and pressure contain equal numbers of molecules. To get the accurate determination of Avogadro's number, the measurement of a single quantity on both the atomic and macroscopic scales using the same unit was required. Robert Millikan made this possible by measuring the charge of the electron. The charge of a mole of electrons is called a Faraday. If you divide the charge on a mole of electrons by the charge on a single electron, you obtain a value of Avogadro's number of 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd power, particles per mole. Jean Baptiste Perrin gave the name of the number in honor of Avogadro.
Now, how do we use Avogadro's number in chemistry? Well, we use Avogadro's number to calculate the number of atoms or molecules present in a substance. We take tiny particles and it makes them tangible.
Alright, so let's just say that there's 22 grams of copper. Hold on, wait for it. There we go. Now we have 22 grams of copper. Alright, let's just say that there's 22 grams of copper and that we're trying to figure out how many atoms are in 22 grams of copper. After you are done that, you write your given. Then, after you write the given, you write down what you are looking for. After writing down your given and identifying what you're looking for, you write down your conversion factor. Next, you start your dimensional analysis. First, you write your given. After writing your given, you then set up a conversion factor to make cancellations of units. Then, you multiply the numbers on the top and then divide the number on the bottom. After you are done doing the math, you finally get what you were looking for.
To promote an interest in chemistry on Mole Day, students around the world come up with their very own mole theme. Each mole theme is different. My mole theme that I came up with was one of my favorite games while growing up, and that is Yu-Gi-Oh! But I changed it to Mole-Gi-Oh!
I summoned my Dark Magician.
Yeah, well, I summoned my blue-eyed mole dragon.
No!
Did you know that each year, Mole Day has a different theme? This year's theme is called Moleween. One stacked mold of paper would reach the moon about 80 billion times. I think we need more paper.
There's approximately 2 mold of stars in the universe.
A mold of donuts would cover the Earth to the depth of 5 miles. Why would we cover the Earth with donuts? I do not know. Well, I hope you guys learned a mole lot of stuff from this video. Have an awesome mole day.